بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بارك الله فيكم من حفظ الأبيات. العلم صيد والكتابة قيده، قيد صيودك بالحبال الواثقة، فمن الحماقة أن تصطاد غزالة وتتركها في الخلائق طالقة. من حفظ؟ حفظ يا عمار. هذه الأبيات جميلة والله سأزيدكم. يا خان محمد حفظ هذه الأبيات. عندك يا نبيل سمعتها من قبل يا عبد الفتاح، فهمتها؟ العلم صيد والكتابة قيدها. نعم، العلم صيد، واحد يصطاد صيد، يصطاد سمكا، يعني غزال، أرنب. نعم، يعني knowledge is a prey. You say my prey, P-R-E-Y. They say P-R-A-Y, P-R-E-Y. You know, something you hunt. It's a prey. نعم. قيد صيودك بالحبال الواثقة. يعني علم صيد والكتابة قيدها. When you write it down, أنت تمسك الفائدة عندما تكتبها، ولكن عندما تجد في الدرس تحفظها تروح عليك ما يبقى. When you sit in the class without a notebook, and the fawaid come, what fawaid? I'm talking about gasoline prices. What are we talking about? The Dow Jones? What are we talking about? The diesel and when benzin? We're talking about ilm, salah, zakah, rabbuk, nabiyuk. يعني شيء يخصك يهمك، something that it benefits you, has to do with you and your family. نعم. وكتابة قيدها، writing it down, it holds it. قيد صيودك بالحبال الواثقة. يعني grab on and hold on to the prey, the things that you hunt, with some strong rope. What is the strong rope? Writing it down. فمن الحماقة أن تصطاد غزالة، تسيد غزالة. From that which doesn't make any sense. ما هو معقول؟ أن واحد يصطاد غزال. هاي شو الغزال؟ ما عندكم في اليمن غزال. طيب. نعم. يعني الغزالة فيها لحم خيد كثير. It's a lot of meat in a deer. It's called a deer. نعم. That you get a deer, and when you get it, you just let it go. تتركها في الخلائق طالقة. After you went to all the trouble to get it, you just let it go away. What did they say? ما كتب قرة وما حفظ فرة. فهمت يا عبد الفتاح؟ That which is written down, it stays. It stays. And that which is memorized, goes. And this is one of the distinguishes, this is the one of the advantages of Sahih Muslim over Sahih Bukhari. In jumla, in general, Sahih Bukhari is a greater book. But Imam Muslim indahu wa yusamma dhabt kitaba. He wrote things down perfectly the way it came. Imam Bukhari has dhabt hifdhin. He just memorized everything. Na'am. So kana fa dhali kana yarwi bil ma'na, laysa bil nafs al nafs. Na'am. Ma ismuk ya akhana? Abdurrahman. Fahimt kalami? Na'am. Imam Bukhari, and it's permissible to narrate by the meaning, not as long as you don't change the meaning. But Imam Muslim came with the exact wording that he got from his sheikh. The exact wording. To the point that he would say, هَذَا قَالَ حَدَّفَنَا وَقَالَ هَذَا قَالَ أَخْبَرَنَا. Just in the words that he received in receiving the hadith. This is just one advantage Muslim has over. فَلَا بُدَّ مِنْهُ. طيب، عندي حديث أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا أراد الله قبض عبد بأرض جعل له إليها حاجة. من صحابيه؟ من أخرجه؟ ما حاله؟ يا نبي، من صحابي هذا الحديث؟ إذا أراد الله قبض عبد بأرض جعل له إليها حاجة. If Allah wants to take his the servant, he wants to take his soul in a particular place, he wants him to die in a particular place, He gives him a hajj. He gives him a need, a purpose to go over there. فكان الشيخ مقبل يدندن ويدندن هذه هذا الحديث لما مرض وذهب إلى السعودية. ما كان في السعودية من 20 سنة بل طرد من البلاد رحمه الله تعالى. When Sheikh Mukbil went back to Saudi, he was reading this hadith. He would say it over and over. He hasn't been there in over how many years? Over 30 years. I said 20, maybe 30, 40 years. He was actually expelled. He was kicked out of the country. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted him to die over there. Subhanallah. Tayyib, hadha hadithu Abu Izza. Hadith. أبو عز حديث أبي عزة حديث أبي عزة ولكن ذكرناه كذلك لأبيات اكتبوها أبيات جميلة سأذكرها مرة ثم سأعيدها نعم لعلكم سمعت بها سمعت بهذه الأبيات يا توفيق مشينا خطا كتبت علينا ومن كتبت عليه خطا مشاها أرزاق لنا متفرقات ومن لم تأته مشا أتاها ومن كتبت منيته بأرض فليس يموت بأرض سواها يا لها من حكمة نعم مشينا خطا كتبت علينا Like we walked footsteps that was pre-decreed for us. It was written down. Allah qaddara hadha for us. وَمَنْ كُتِبَتْ عَلَيْهِ خُطًا مَشَاهَا Whoever's decreed for him that he's going to take some footsteps, he's going to take them footsteps. He's going to walk that direction. أَرْزَاقٌ لَنَا مُتَفَرِّقَاتٌ The provisions that's for us is of different kinds. متفرقات. Separate. Different varieties. فَمَنْ لَمْ تَأْتِهِ مَشْيًا أَتَاهَا Yeah, subhanAllah. Whoever doesn't go and get his risk and actually go get it, it's going to come to him. It's going to come to him. It's written down for you. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ مَنِيَّتُهُ بِأَرْضٍ Whoever his death is going to be in a particular land, فَلَيْسَ يَمُوتُ بِأَرْضٍ سِوَى He's not going to die in any other place. هذه أبيات جميلة. مسموك يا أخانا؟ أنت؟ خطاب تحفظ هذه الآيات هذه الأبيات لابد أن تكتب نعم مشينا خطا كتبت علينا مشينا خطا كتبت علينا ومن كتبت عليه خطا مشاها أرزاق لنا متفرقات فمن لم تأته مشيا أتاها ومن كانت أو من كتبت منيته بأرض فليس يموت في أرض سباها كل هذه حكمة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن في الشعر لحكمة في الشعر حكمة نعم هذه حكمة لما كنت في اليمن أنا كنت أتعلم اللغة العربية إذا أسمع شعر خلاص أغمد أذني وعني أنا ما أفهم ما أريد أفر منها نعم حتى كنت بدأت أستمع إليه نعم وأستمع أكثر وأستمع أكثر حتى أحببتها نعم When I first started was I was young Yemen learning Arabic I they used to say poetry but I would just flee away from it I wouldn't even try to listen to it because it was just too confusing نعم But when I started to pay attention to it, MashaAllah fiha khair. اليوم وصلنا إلى في درسنا في التفسير إلى سورة الإخلاص وهذه سورة عظيمة سورة عظيمة نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يبارك لنا في معاني هذه السورة وفهمها يوفقنا إلى فهمها آمين الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول في هذه السورة بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد قل هو الله أحد. Say he is Allah one. Allah الصمد. Allah is الصمد. And the meaning of that is going to come. لم يلد. He doesn't have any children. لم يلد. ولم يولد. He's not the son of anyone. ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. And nothing is equal to him. هذه صورة فيها معاني وفيها كذلك بارك الله فيكم فضائل. فننظر إلى فضائلها وهذا يحثنا على معرفة معانيها. This surah has meaning to it, meanings and benefits, but it also has, barakallahu fik, ماذا? It has virtues of the surah. So we want to read the virtues of it, and knowing the virtues of something, يحثها على معرفتها. This will encourage you to learn more about it. Now when you hear the virtues of it, but the فائدة الذي فيه, and the benefits that's in it. جاء في الصحيح عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه أن رجلا سمع رجلا يقرأ قل هو الله أحد يرددها. Abu Sa'id said, a man heard another man. He's speaking about himself. He heard Qatada, reading قل هو الله أحد, and he was repeating it over and over. This is the only surah he was reading at night. This surah by itself. فلما أصبح جاء إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فذكر ذلك له كأن الرجل يتقالها. When the morning came, he went and he told the prophet, this guy was praying at night and he's just reading قل هو الله أحد قل هو الله أحد قل هو الله أحد, as if he made small of it or saw that you shouldn't just يقتصر على هذا, that you shouldn't just be suffice with this, you should read other than that, that this is not sufficient. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والذي نفسي بيده إنها لتعدل ثلث القرآن. I swear by the one that my soul is in his hand, it is equivalent to a third of the Quran. فهذه سورة عظيمة وفيها عدة أحاديث تدل على هذا. There are numerous hadiths that indicate this, that this surah is equivalent to a third of the Quran. The likes of it comes on also Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu. أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لأصحابه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to his companions, أيعجز أحدكم أن يقرأ ثلث القرآن في ليلة فشق ذلك عليه. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to his companions, is one of you incapable of reading a third of the Quran at night? That was difficult for them. And he told them, then he left them, and they found that it was difficult. فَقَالُوا أَيُّنَا يُطِيقُ ذَلِكَ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. They said, which of us is able to do that, O Messenger of Allah, to read a third of the Quran at night? فقال الله الواحد الصمد ثلث القرآن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't say the exact words of the Quran, ولكن ذكره بالكناية بالمعنى الواحد الصمد. This surah where it mentions that Allah is one, that He is الصمد, meaning سورة الإخلاص, ثلث القرآن is the third of the Quran. And his hadith, أهل العلم يقول, نقرأ الحديث بعد هذا, that a third of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran as-sifat, sifatahu, sifatihi subhanahu wa ta'ala. He mentions his descriptions, his names and his descriptions. So the descriptions of Allah is a portion of the Quran. So that's one third. The other two portions are ahkam, the rules and regulations of Islam, and the other portion wa qisas al-anbiya, or the stories of the Prophet. So it's just not confined. ما هي منحصر على هذا. When we say قصص الأنبياء, all the stories are not of أنبياء. For example, لقمان هو ليس بنبي. ففي قصص وغيرها للأنبياء. Along with صفات الله, هناك صفات الساعة, صفات يوم القيامة. وأسمائه, and his names, نعم. And also is the rules and regulations of Islam, الأحكام, نعم. الأحكام, نعم. فمن هذه الناحية هي تعديل ثلث القرآن. But this surah is Ikhlas. It's specifically about Allah from the beginning of it to the end of it. من أوله إلى آخرها. من أوله إلى آخرها. From the beginning of it to the end of it is about Allah and His descriptions. Like what? Like Ayatul Kursi. هذه الآية كله صفات الله. نعم. All of it is descriptions of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وجاء عن كتادة عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن الله جزأ القرآن ثلاثة أجزاء فجعل قل هو الله أحد جزءا من أجزاء القرآن. هذا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah made the Quran in three sections and He made قل هو الله أحد a section from the sections of the Quran. In a third. Al-Ahadith fi hadha al-ma'na, they are numbered. There's a number of them, but we like to read them because some of us maybe we have not heard of it. Ja'a fi sahih. What does this mean if I say Ja'a fi sahih? What does it mean Ja'a fi sahih? It could be Bukhari or Muslim. It could be Bukhari or Muslim. Is everything in Bukhari and Muslim authentic? Are there hadiths that are criticized? Muntaqada? من يجيب؟ نعم في أحاديث منتقدة والكمال لله سبحانه وتعالى. نعم. There are hadiths that are criticized, but you don't say it's weak. نعم. Weak is something that's ظاهر, is clearly العلة, is a clear something wrong with it. But this is something that the people of hadith وعلل detected in some of the hadiths. نعم. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أحشدوا فإني سأقرأ عليكم ثلث القرآن فحشد من حشد. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, gather up the people. I'm going to read to you all a third of the Quran. So some people gathered up whoever they could gather up because the Prophet is going to read a third of the Quran. ثم خرج النبي الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقرأ قل هو الله أحد ثم دخل. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came out, he read, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ صَرَةُ الْإِخْلَاسِ, then he went back inside. فَقَالَ بَعْدُهُمْ لِبَعْدٍ إِنِّي أَرَى هَذَا خَبْرٌ جَاءَهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَذَاكَ الَّذِي أَدْخَلَهُ. They said, we see that this is some information, some revelation came to him from the sky, some revelation came, so he went back inside because revelation was coming down on him. فخرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet came out and said, إني قلت لكم سأقرأ عليكم ثلث القرآن على إنها تعجل ثلث القرآن. The Prophet said, I said to you all that I was going to read a third of the Quran. Verily, that is equivalent to a third of the Quran. فهذا كان تعليما له. That's his method of teaching it to them. سبحانه وتعالى. This surah, this chapter in it is the descriptions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His names and descriptions, there's rules and regulations that many of the Muslims are unaware of. We want to mention some of them tonight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allahu la ilaha illa hu lahul asma'ul husna. Allah, there is nothing worthy of worship other than Him. For Him is Al-Asma Al-Husna. For Him is the most beautiful of names. طيب الآن درسن. عندنا درس في اللغة العربية. We have a درس in things of Arabic. Al-Husna. What is this word Al-Husna? Is it a verb? هل هو فعل? هل هو اسم? Is it a name? Is it a sifa? What is this al-husna? What does al-husna mean? Is it jama'? Is it singular? Is it plural? هل هو مذكر؟ هل هو مؤنث؟ What is this husna?
اسم جامع.
اسم جامع. لا ما أسأل as far as نحو. Is it the مبتدا or خبر? I'm not asking as far as نحو. I'm asking, هل هو فعل؟
هل هو
الاسم؟ في ألف لام الحسنى. Is it جمع? Is it plural? Is it مفرد? Is it plural? And who is جمع? How we know it's جمع? Because it says أسماء. الأسماء الحسنى. نعم. Because أسماء is جمع. نعم. الأسماء is جمع. نعم. So if I'm going to describe something that's جمع, I have to use a word that's جمع. If I'm going to describe something that's plural, I have to use something that's plural. طيب. الحسنى is plural. السؤال. ما هو المفرد?
حسن.
What is the مفرد? عبد الفتاح قال حسن. ما نقبل هذا. نعم. أنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الرجل قال يا رسول الله الرجل يحب أن يكون ثوبه حسن ونعله حسنة. نعم. فحسنة is not the plural for حسن. حسنة is plural. What is the مفرد? من قال أحسن? أحسن الله إليك. أحسنت. الله يزيدك من فضلي. أحسنت. ثم أحسنت. نعم. أجاب أبو بلال. The plural for حسنة is أحسن. يعني الاسم الأحسن الأسماء الحسنة. What does أحسن mean? أحسن means هو اسم تفضيل. It means better. I say زيد أحسن من محمد. أمر أحسن من عثمان. نعم. It means زيد is better than محمد. أحمد is better than عثمان. It's اسم تفضيل. تفضيل يدل على المشاركة في شيء أحدهما أكثر من الثاني. نعم. اسم تفضيل, when you say تفضيل, it means both of these people, they have this description, one is greater than the other. If I say زكريا أسرع من زيد, زكريا is faster than زيد. Is زيد slow? No, زيد is fast also. نعم. Is مشاركة في الصفة. نعم. ولكن زكريا is faster. I'm not saying زكريا سريع, لا, زكريا أسرع. من زيد. I described him that he's fast and that he's faster. He's quicker than. نعم. It has to be something else that's in there. It has to be comparison. نعم. That is the best of names. For if it's singular, الاسم الأحسن, the best name. But if it's plural, الأسماء, you can't say الأسماء الأحسن. الأسماء الحسنى. The best of names. The best name, الاسم الأحسن. The best names, الأسماء الحسنى يا عبد الرحمن. فهمت هذا؟ يا يونس أنت معنا. طيب. هذا يوصلنا إلى سؤال ثاني. Why is Allah's names the best of names? لماذا أسماء الله حسنى? بأي دليل they're the best names? نعم هذا منها. We have to look at why are they the best of names. First in أذكرها. Why he has the best of names. ما شاء الله أنت في الطريق يا محمد. الله يزيدك من فضل. طيب الأول أسماء الله كلها دالة على مدح. All of them are names that indicate مدح and praise. نعم. It's not like a name that doesn't have any praise to it, anything to it. Yeah. What if somebody's name was ما أريد أذكر اسم أحد الأكوة هنا, ولكن اسم ليس فيها معنى الذي يدل على مدح. نعم. Days. لو كان اسم الواحد اسمه ديزل أو اسمه دايز أو اسمه إيش خشب اسمه إيش هواء أو يعني اسم ما يدل على شيء. نعم. It doesn't indicate any praise. Every name of Allah is a meaning of praise, goodness. اختار حفيظ اختار سميع. طيب Allah's name is سميع. Is it praiseworthy to be سميع or أسم? Which one is praiseworthy? To be deaf or to be hearing? To be hearing. No. هو بصير. ايش هو ايش 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 المدى الاعمى والبصير which one to be blind to be seen every name الله قدير العاجز والقدير the one who's incapable the one who's capable الله عليم كيف الجاهل والعليم somebody is knowing or is ignorant which one is praiseworthy Allah doesn't have a name except في مدى لا اسم من أسمائه ولا شيء من أسمائه إلا فيه ثناء هذا ليس من أسماء الناس أسماء الناس لهم يعني أسماء ليس لا يدل على معاني لا يدل على معاني طلحة ما إيش معنى طلحة اسم اسم من الصحابة لكن اسم لا يستخرج منها المعاني أنه البطل القوي القادر الاسم نعم فهذا الأول that's the first reason every name of him فيه مدى نعم طيب الثاني أنها ليست أعلام محضة إنما هي أسماء وأوصاف that the names of Allah is not just a name like my name is Abdul Hakim ممكن الرجل اسمه صالح هو طالح نعم Maybe somebody's name is Salih. It means that's a good name. Salih. Na'am. But it's Salih. It's not righteous. It's not righteous at all. Mungkin somebody's name is Shamsuddin or huwa Zalamuddin. Na'am. Somebody's name is Shamsuddin. He's the light and the sun of the religion. In reality, he's the darkness of the religion. Nothing good about him. So his name is just a name. Na'am. His name is just a name. It's not a description for him. Maybe his name is Qawi and he's daif. Maybe his name is Tawil and he's Qasir. Maybe his name is Tall and he's short. Maybe his name is Jameel and he's not Jameel. Nuh-uh. So our names are just names. Allah's names. Kullu ism lahu sifa. In fin kana ismuhu Qawi, haqqan huwa Qawi. Man kana ismuhu Basir, huwa Yubsir. What kind of, if his name is the all-seeing, he sees. If his name is Samia, huwa yasma. If his name is the all-hearing, indeed he can hear. If his name is Rahman, huwa yarham. If his name is Rahman, huwa indeed he shows mercy. Wa ghana dhalik min asma'ihi. Every name that he has is a description. It's not just a name. Who has names like that that they live up to? Maybe the up, you say, this is my son. I know he sent me and he's trying to pick a good name. But the son doesn't live up to it. ما يحققها. نعم. هذا من توفيق الله. محقق. نعم. Okay. Allah's names, they're a name and it's also a description. هو وصف له أيضا. ليس مجرد أعلام محضة. Not that just names by themselves. أسماء وأوصاف. That's the second reason. The first one is what? أنه كلها مدح. All of them are مدح. The second one, that is the name, and Allah has a description itself. Not just a nice pretty name. Whoa, that's a nice name. Nah, it's a nice name. Wa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, huwa mawsufan bihi. And Allah is described by this also. It's not just a nice name with a good meaning. Allah, He fulfills that meaning. The third. أنها دالة على الصفات الكاملة. نعم. له هذه الصفة أكملها وأعمها وأجلها. فالله سبحانه وتعالى إذ هو موصوف بقوة القوة الكاملة. لو كان موصوفا بالبصر يبصر كل شيء لا يفوته شيء. من كان موصوفا بالسمع سمعه يسمع كل شيء. ليس فيه نقص بوجه من الوجوه على الشكل الكامل. نعم. That if he's Allah, if he's described with something, he's described with this in the most fullest of degree. If he can see, he can see everything. وهو بكل شيء عليم بكل شيء بصير. He is seeing everything. He has knowledge of everything. He doesn't have knowledge of some things. No. If he has knowledge, his knowledge is kamil. If he has quwwa, quwwa kamil. If he has strength, his strength is complete. Now we have descriptions. We have descriptions of strength. It's not complete. We have descriptions of sabr. We have patience. It's not complete. نعم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا أحد أصبر على عذى سمعه من الله. Nobody is more patient than Allah. Nobody is more patient on the annoyance that they hear than Allah. If he has a sifa, he is the top. He has the sifa kamilan. He has his description completely. Ala akmal al wajh, in the most complete way. Hadha nu'iduhu. The first reason. Limadha asma Allah al-husna. Why is his name the best names? Awwal in every name yadullu ala madhan. Every name it indicates goodness, praise. Wa laysa asma mahdan. It's not just names. They're names, and he has the sifa that goes along with it. A third, he doesn't have the sifa, but I can sifa ala akmal al wajh. Ala akmal al wajh. نعم طيب الرابع أن الله أمر العباد أن يدعوه بها. Allah commanded us to call him by these names. ولله الأسماء الحسنى فادعوه بها. يعني نحن نتقرب إلى الله بأسمائه وصفاته. We get closer to Allah by calling his name. Calling his names. But if you want some provision, say, Ya Razak, Urzuqni. Ya Rahman, Irhamni. Ya Manan, Munna Alayya. Naam. Allah tells us to call Allah, worship Him, Nataqarrab Ilayhi, to get closer to Him by calling on His names. Whose other name can you call? Get some benefit from just by calling that name. You're going to say, Ya Zayd. Ya Tajir, what are you going to call? Get some benefit. It's going to guarantee you something. There's no name that has barakah like that. Naam fi khair. Naam. Wa fi ahadith, an-Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, inna lillahi tis'atan wa tis'in isman, man hafidhaha dakhal al-jannah. Ya ijma' al-asma' al-dunya. Ay al-asma' satahfaduha wa laka ajr. الأعظم الأجور جنة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah has 99 names. So this is not limiting his names to 99. لا والله ما هي محصورة على 99 على 99. It's not limited to 99, but there's 99 that has this reward attached to it. نعم. Allah has 99 names. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, whoever memorizes them enters Jannah. What names are you going to memorize? Memorize everything in this world. What names are you going to get a reward just for memorizing? When memorizing it means يَحْفَظُهَا يَعْلَمْ مَعَانِيهَا وَيَعْمَلْ بِمُقْتَدَاهَا. أن الله رقيب عليك أن الله ينظر إليك أن المبصر وأن السميع والبصير. نعم وأنه على كل شيء قدير. نعم فلذلك لا تغفل عنه ولا تيأس من رحمته. نعم غير ذلك. نعم. How can somebody despair of the mercy of Allah إلا أنه ما يعرف صفات ربي. نعم. He doesn't know. How can somebody despair from the mercy of Allah except you don't ما تعرف ربك. You don't know who your Lord is, who created you. ما تعرف. نعم. الله سبحانه وتعالى قال ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم. Don't be like those who forgot Allah, for Allah made them forget their own selves. قال ابن قيم من هذه الآية. قال ماذا؟ بارك الله فيكم. من علم الله، من عرف الله، عرف ما سواه. ومن جهل الله، فهو لما سواه أجهل. من عليك؟ ما عرفت ربك، فغير الله أنت أجهل. استحل يا عبد الفتاح أنت مائي فهمت هذا إن شاء الله طيب ابن الله سبحانه وتعالى says يا أنس أنت معنا حياك حياك. الله سبحانه وتعالى says don't be like those who forget Allah. Allah made them forget their own selves. نعم forget their own selves. ابن القيم قال من عرف الله, whoever knows Allah, عرف ما سواه, he knows everything other than Allah, knows the halal, knows the haram, I know what Allah likes, I know what Allah doesn't like, I know what Allah rewards for, I know what Allah punishes for, I know what guides to Allah, I know what takes me further away from Allah. Na'am, man عرف الله. Na'am. وإيش جاء الرسل من أجل إيش؟ وليش نزلت الكتب من أجل إيش؟ حتى نعرف ربنا. نعم. Why did Allah send the prophets? Why did Allah descend books? So we can know Allah, how to worship Him. Now we have a purpose here. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون الله. نعم. I haven't created the jinn or man except that we worship Allah. How are you going to worship Allah? How are we going to know? بالرسل وبالكتب. There's no other way. So the further you are away from the Rusul and from the Kutub, the further you are away, the further you are away from من تحقيق يعني سبب حياتك وجودك على هذه البسيطة. The further you are away from that, the further you are away from completing and fulfilling and carrying out and executing your purpose on the face of the earth. وَمَنْ جَهِلَ اللَّهِ, whoever is ignorant of Allah, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah said, whoever is ignorant of Allah, then other than Allah, he's more ignorant. He doesn't know Allah. He doesn't know halal. Doesn't know haram. ما يعرف من ينفع. ما ينفع. مصلحة نفسي. That which is beneficial for him. That which harms him. What Allah loves. What Allah hates. How to please his Lord. Na'am. How to make tawbah to Allah. Na'am. فهذا كلها من المعنى that Allah, He has the most beautiful of names. سأسألكم من الغد. سأسألكم من الغد. لابد أن تحفظ هذا دينك. هذا دينك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قل ادعوا الله أو ادعوا الرحمن أيما تدعوا فلكل الأسماء الحسنى يا سبحان الله. Yani, when we look at our deen and you compare it to the Yahud and Nasara, you call, Ya Rabbana Akramtana. You can't say anything else. When you look at our religion and you look at what the Jews have left from their religion and what the Christians have left from their religion, you can say, Allah, you've honored me. I didn't pay for this. I didn't work for it. Okay. It just came to me. No. Allah says, قُلْ إِدْعُوا اللَّهِ, say to the Muhammad, call on Allah, say, Ya Allah, أو إِدْعُوا الرَّحْمَن, or call الرَّحْمَن, أَيِّمَّا تَدْعُوا, whichever names you call, he has the most beautiful of names, call whatever name you want, according to your situation. Nah? من, who has that اختيار? I don't know. مَنْ فُدِّلَ بِهَذَا الْفَضْلِ, who has been given his honor to do this? المسلمون. أنت في نعمة والله أنت في نعمة لا تنكرها. You in a نعمة, you cannot deny it. You can't deny it. هذا فضل. ولكن كم منا يفوتنا هذا؟ قال الله ما تقول يا الله يا رحمن يا رحيم يا رزاق رزقني يا سميع. أنت سميع الدعاء. You don't want to hear the دعاء. أشتكي إليك. I complain to you. وأنت ودود. You're the loving. وأنت الرؤوف الرحيم. You're the kind. أنت غافر. أنت غفور. أنت غفار. وأنت خير الغافرين. وأنت العفو. اعفو عني. Now these are names that Allah has. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم يخبرنا عن صفات الله. He قال اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو. واش من أخبرنا بهذا الشيء؟ نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى نعرفها نستفيد منها نعمل بها. نعم. Oh Allah, you are afu. You are the one that pardons. تحب العفو. You love to pardon. خلاص gather up the kufar. Explain to us what your Lord, your Jallah loves and what He hates. ما دريت أنا ما أعرف. يا لها من فائدة. To know that when you fell in sin, that your Lord loves al-afu. He loves the pardon. Ya subhanAllah. What an encouragement for you to make tawbah. Hal taba ahad wa khasir? Ya Muhammad. Hal taba ahad wa khasir? La ma'akya ma'akya. life. Nah. Has anyone ever made tauba and he lost out? He went because of his tauba, he lost. Nah. Anybody make tauba? He's successful. Nah. فمعرفة أسماء الله وصفاته من أعظم الأمور. نعم. أعظم العلوم. هو أعظم العلوم على الإطلاق. It's the most beneficial thing you can know. Because if you're ignorant of this, I don't care what you know after this. ما ينفعش. ما ينفعك. It's not going to benefit you anything. If you don't know who your Lord is and what he likes and what he dislikes, it's constant. You're a loser. مهما تجتهد وتفعل وتعمل وتفعل نعم فهذه الأمور التي يقوم الناس ويذكر المسلمين. These are the things that straighten your back up. نعم. And take the fog out of your eyes so you can see clearly. إنما تذكر الناس بالله وتذكرهم بيوم القيامة. هذه أقوى شيء في نفوس الناس. أوقع في نفوسهم. These are the deepest things that penetrate somebody's heart. فلذلك في آيات وأحاديث كثيرة من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر يؤمن بالله واليوم أعظم شيء. أعظم شيء. فالآن we want to look at something else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يهدد من يذكره على غير وصفه ويكذب عليه. Allah threatens those that describe him with other than the descriptions that's not for him. How would you like somebody describe you something that's not suitable for you? How would you like that? Hey, come on. Don't do that. Don't call me that. Nah. You might say, listen, say that I'm a little slow. Don't call me a liar. Don't say that. Nah, don't call me a liar. You don't like that. Now, if somebody says something that was true about you, he's weak. Okay, say that I'm weak. Don't call me a liar. Don't say that. I'm not a liar. Nah. And then that nuks. We have deficiencies. But Allah, I'm not doing nuks. What if somebody describes Allah with deficiency? Nah. Annahu nam. Annahu istaraha. That he slept. That he took a break and he relaxed. Ash'adha kalam. What are you saying? Nah. Is this big to say something about Allah and it's not true? Or it's just, I don't make a big thing about it? Naqra. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا وَذَرُ الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ سَيُجْزَوْنَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. هذا تهديد. To Allah belongs the most beautiful names. Call him Biha. Call him by his name. Don't call him by something else. وَذَرُ الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ مَا مَنَا وَذَرُ. وهذا في القرآن كثير. ذرني ومن يكذب بهذا الحديث. ذرني. Leave them for me. I'm going to deal with them. هذا تهديد. Can you imagine a threat more than that? Leave them alone. I'm going to deal with them. Allah saying leave them alone. Leave them for me. I'm going to deal with them. Ya subhanAllah. Nah, that's a threat for those who describe Allah other than what he is. وَذَلِلَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ. Leave them alone, the ones that change and go astray in the names of Allah. Leave them alone. So you جَزَوْنَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَنُونَ. They are going to be rewarded for what they do. He didn't say, I'm going to reward them. He didn't even say it. I mean, it's known. So you جَزَوْنَ. They're going to be rewarded. Leave them. They're going to be rewarded for what they did. What did they do? Al-Hadu fi asma'illah. They want to stray in the names of Allah, calling him other than his names. Na'am. Allah ma yuhib hadha. Ma yuhib hadha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna alladhina yulhiduna fi ayatina la yakhfawna alayna. Ready those that go astray concerning our signs. ومن آيات الله أسمائه وصفاته وأفعاله. How do we know Allah? How do we know Allah? We know Allah by His names, His descriptions, and His actions. هذه آياتي. فالذين يلحدون في هذه الأشياء. Those who go astray in these signs, لا يخفون علينا. They're not hidden from us. I see them. This is a tahdeed. This is a threat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in Surah Tuhud, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمْ مِنْ مَنِ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. هذه في آيات عديدة. Who is more wrong than the one that invents a lie about Allah? عندي سؤال وقد أخذنا هذا من قبل. I have a question. We took this before. ماذا يفيد هذا الاستفهام? What does this question convey? ماذا يفيد الاستفهام? نعم يا غالب.
That's the worst. It's no one other.
نعم عم لكن أريد الكلمة. أنت فيه. نعم. ماذا يفيد الاستفهام في هذه الآية? بمعنى النفي. قل هكذا. بمعنى النفي. الاستفهام شبه نفي. بمعنى ومن أظلم ليس أحد أظلم منها. Who's more wrong? Meaning nobody is more wrong and more oppressive that lies about Allah. That's the biggest sin you can do. لا أحد أظلم من هذا. ومن أظلم لا أحد أظلم. بمعنى نفي negation. نعم. And remember that when you read the Quran. That at istifham sometimes هو شب نفي. It's like negating. نعم. Allah said there's, who's more wrong than the one who lies and makes a lie up about Allah. What does Allah say after that? أُولَٰئِكَ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. These people that lie about Allah, they're going to be presented before Allah. يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. They're going to be presented before Allah يوم القيامة. وَيَقُولُ الْأَشْهَادُ هَٰؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ عَلَىٰ لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ الظَّالِمِينَ. Ya Subhanallah, sallam, sallam, ya Rabbana. They're going to present it before Allah. And then the witnesses are going to say, from amongst the Anbiya, wal Malaika, wal Salihin. They're going to say, these are the ones that lied about their Lord. May the curse of Allah be on the wrongdoers. هَٰؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ. These are the ones that lied upon Allah. طيب أسوفيا وغيرهم يقول الله في كل مكان. Allah is in every place. هذا كذب. That's a lie on Allah. Allah is everywhere. He's in the hammam. What book? He's everywhere. He's in the bar. Nah. What book? Fikuli Mekan? How can I have it? You can just say about Allah what you want. If somebody said that your mother or your father was in some places. Laza'at kan darraba ya hazam. Hazam and tma'i. Nah, that's a big statement. Somebody say your mother was in a certain place. Oh, shh. Right, now you just can't come out your face and say anything about my mother. I'm not having that. Mm-mm. What about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What about Allah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تَرَى الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ وُجُوهُهُمْ مُسْوَدَّةِ أَلَيْسَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ مَثْوًا لِلْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ. And you will see on Yawm al-Qiyamah, you will see those that lied on Allah, their face is going to be black. They're going to be distinguished for our punishment. وكل هذه الآيات يدل على هذا أنه وعيد شديد. الفضل, first of all, the fadl just to know the names of Allah. And to memorize it, to know the meaning of it. And يعمل بمقتضاه, and the work according to it. Imagine if you know that Allah is Ghafir. These are all names, they convey forgiveness. Ghafir, Ghafur, Ghafar, Khairu Ghafirin, هو عفو. كيف تيأس من مغفرته وعفوه? How could you despair? It's going to encourage you to give more, to make istighfar all the time. وهو الرحمن, وهو الرحيم, هو خير الرحيمين, هو أرحم الرحيمين, وهو الرؤوف. نعم, he's kind, he's merciful. هو القوي, هو القادر, وهو القدير, وهو المقتدر. يعني three names مشتق that come from the same root of capability. لا يعجز, he's not incapable. The more you know, the more it's going to make your iman stronger. Now, the more you know about Allah, it benefits you. نعم. جاء عن عائشة رضي الله عنها عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعث رجلا على سرية. The Prophet sent a man in charge of a group, of an army. He was in charge of them. وَكَانَ يَقْرَأْ لِأَصْحَابِهِ فَصَلَاتِ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ. He used to lead them in salah. وَكَانَ يَخْتَمْ بِقُلُّهُ وَاللَّهُ أَحَدْ. If he read from Fatiha and he read any other surah after Fatiha, he always made the last thing he read before ruku' قُلْهُ وَاللَّهُ أَحَدْ. He always would end it saying قُلْ with that surah, قُلْهُ وَاللَّهُ أَحَدْ. فَلَمَّا رَجَعُوا ذَكَرُوا ذَلِكَ لِلنَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So they, when they reached back, they told the Prophet what their leader of the army was doing. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سلوه لأي شيء يصنع ذلك. The Prophet said, go ask him. For what reason did he do that? Why was he doing that? Go ask him. فسألوه, they asked him, قال فإنها صفة الرحمن. It's a description of Ar-Rahman, that he's one. Though everything that's in this ayah, that he's one. And he's As-Samad, that the meaning is going to come. لم يلد ولم يولد. He has no children. He's not the children of anything. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. And there's nothing similar to him. This is صفة الرحمن. This is the description of the most merciful. وَأَنَا أُحِبْ أَنْ أَقْرَأَهَا. I love to read this. إِجْلَالٍ لِلَّهِ. An honor of Allah. I love to read this. قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ أَخْبِرُوهُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ. Allah, the Prophet said, go inform him that Allah loves him. And this is an encouragement for us. Is it just encouragement for us to read قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ at the end of the surah? No. But none of the Sahabas did this. None of the Sahabas. Is it encouragement for us to know Allah by His descriptions and to love Him for it? Nah. It's encouragement for us to know Allah. Hey, what? Where are you going to love Allah? Based on what? Based on asma'ihi. If you know the meaning of it, give it out to Hibbu. Nah. But he attached to Dabbar. This Sahabi, he was thinking about the meaning of it. Had this sifat. He liked to say these sifat because he knows the meaning of it. It's azim. Especially when you see those that are worshipping other than Allah. SubhanAllah. Allah wahdahu yastahiq hadhi al-ibadah. Ja'an Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu. Wahuwa fi al-sahih. Qala Allah ta'ala. Hadith Qudsi. كذبني ابن آدم ولم يكن له ذلك ولم يكن له ذلك شتمني ولم يكن له ذلك. Ibn Adam has lied on me, and that's not suitable for him to do. Humanity. Ibn Adam meaning humanity. وشتمني, he has insulted me, and that's not suitable for him to do that. فأما تكذيبه إياي, as far as for him lying on me, that he's not going to resurrect me. Allah's not going to resurrect me. That's a lie. He lied on me. Saying I'm not going to resurrect him. وَكَمَا بَدَأَنِي لَيْسَ أَوَّلُ خَلْقِ بِأَهْوَنْ. لَا لَنْ يُعِيدَنِي كَمَا بَدَأَنِي. He's not going to bring me back like he started, like I was at the beginning. And Allah says, وَلَيْسَ أَوَّلُ خَلْقِ بِأَهْوَنْ عَلَيَّ مِنْ إِعْدَادِهِ. He said, the beginning of it, it's not easier or any different from me bringing them back alive. All of it is sahal al-Allah. وَعَمَّا شَتْمُهُ إِيَّاي. As far as him insulting me, فَقَوْلُهُ اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا. And they say that Allah has a son. Allah has a child, even if it's a girl or a boy. He says, وَأَنَا Al-Ahad As-Samad. I am Al-Ahad. I am Al-Ahad As-Samad. Lam Adid. I have no children. Walam Ulad. I'm not the children of anyone. Walam Yakun Kufuwan Ahad. Wal Yakun Li Kufuwan Ahad. And there is nobody that's equal to me. Meaning the wording of this same surah here. فَقُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَد. This conveys that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. Na'am. بذاته وفي أسمائه وصفاته لا يشاركه أحد في هذه الأسماء. نعم. الله الصمد هو الذي لا يحتاج إلى شيء وكل شيء محتاج إليه. والخلاصة قد ضاق الوقت. He is the one that is not in need of anything, and everything else is in need of him. Adam and As-Samad. Ya ayyuhan nas antum al-fuqara'u ila Allah, wallahu huwa al-ghaniyyu al-hamid. Oh mankind, you are the ones in need of Allah, and Allah is not in need of anything. Praiseworthy. Huwa al-ghaniyyu al-hamid. He's not in need of anything, but with that he's praiseworthy. Have you find somebody who's not in need of anything? He's arrogant. Like Allah's not in need of anything, and he's praiseworthy. Lam yadid wa lam yulad. He doesn't have any children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned that the disbelievers in the time of the Prophet, they didn't like to be attributed to them a daughter. And they attributed to Allah, say that the malaika abanatullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا بُشِرَ أَحَدُهُمْ بِمَا ضَرَبَ لِلرَّحْمَنِ مَثَلًا ظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْوَدًّا وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ أَوَمَنْ يُنَشَأَ فِي الْحِلْيَةِ وَهُوَ فِي الْخِصَامِ غَيْرُ مُبِينٍ. Allah says, if one of them was given the good news of that which they make similar to a Rahman, meaning a girl. They attribute girls and daughters to Allah. If one of them was told that you just had a girl, your wife had a girl, ظَلَّ وَجُّهُ مُسْوَدًّا, his face would turn black. وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ, he would be upset and anxiety because of that. أَوَمَنْ يُنَشَّعُ فِي الْحِلْيَةِ, you're going to attribute to something that it needs gold and things to beautify it. نعم. وَهُوَ فِي الْخِصَامِ غَيْرُ مُبِينٍ, and it has deficiency in speaking and at the time of differences. And other than that, the time is short. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ, there is nothing similar to him. Nothing one كُفُوًا. كُفُوًا. There's nothing similar to him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ, there is nothing like him. So when Allah says there's nothing like him, وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ, and he's hearing and he's seeing, time other than Allah hears and sees. There's animals that see in here. Human beings see in here. Allah said, "Laysa kamithlihi shay." There's nothing like him. Meaning his hearing also, there's nothing like it. And his seeing, there's nothing like it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nakhtam bihada. Allah rabbu samawati wal ardi wa ma baynahuma fa'abudhu. واصطبر لعبادتي هل تعلم له سمية يعني مثيلة. Allah says, the Lord of the heavens and the earth and that which is between it, فاعبده, worship him. واصطبر لعبادتي, be consistent and patient on his ibadah, be patient. هل تعلم له سمية, you know anything like him? هذا سؤال لا بد تجيب, هذا سؤال لكل واحد. هل تعلم, this has a mufrad. It's not هل يعلمون, do they know? Look at the demeanor in the Quran. Look at the pronoun. هل تعلم أنت أيها المستمع أيها القارئ, you the one that's listening to the Quran, or you who's reading the Quran, هل تعلمه سميع, you know anything like him? والله والله يا رب ما عرفنا شيئا مثلك, we don't know anything like you. This pronoun is for you, the reader. It's for you, the listener. Jawib, answer the question. La ya Rabbi, wallah, ma khatra bi bali shay'in mithl. God the book, your anger, I can't picture anything like your anger. Your mercy, I can't picture anything. Atamanna ashuf wajhak, I desire to see your face. Nahnu muqassirun. Alladhi yadhkur Allah yartah. Alladhi yadhkur Allah. يا رتاح نص الله سبحانه وتعالى يبارك لنا في ديننا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك إن شاء الله لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.